Octavius Miller, shocked at what he saw inside Georgia Republican Congressman Drew Ferguson's office.
The first thought that came to my mind was to flip the bookcase over.
Right there, on a bookshelf encased in glass, the book General Robert Edward Lee, Soldier, Citizen, and Christian Patriot, a biography of the Civil War general, open to a page highlighting the racist ideology of the time.
That's when we found out that the book had some quotes from General Robert E. Lee that were very, very anti-African American.
The quote on that page, the blacks are immeasurably better off here than in Africa, morally, socially, and physically. The painful discipline they are undergoing is necessary for their instruction as a race, and I hope will prepare and lead them to better things.
It was just disrespectful.
Because of a scheduling conflict, Miller and his fellow union members were unable to meet with Ferguson, but a representative from the group later called the congressman's office to complain about what they saw. The next day, the congressman's chief of staff called Miller to privately apologize and tell him the book had been removed. In an interview with CNN, Ferguson blamed the book's presence on his staff and said it did not represent his own views.
I did not realize that the book was in the office. The staff decorated the office when we moved in. It's not something that I ever remember seeing there. I certainly was offended by the remarks in that book, as anybody would be, and that's why it's no longer in the office.
But Ferguson acknowledged he has read parts of it before.
There were parts of that I found completely against my ideology and my belief system. And so, no, I have not delved deep into that book, but I certainly have studied that subject in other ways. It's an important part of our American history so that we can learn from it and not make the same mistakes.
The union contends the book's placement was no accident and wants a formal public apology from the congressman, not from his staff member.
We've already done that. We spoke to the gentleman. I think we're good.
Now, I spoke with Republican leadership. Steve Scalise's office said that they were just happy that the congressman dealt with this swiftly and that the book is no longer in his office.